Rise above the storm and you will find the sunshine. With this quotation, I, Shivani Alak, welcome you all to the Sense Independence. So let's begin with today's latest BuzzFeed. Actor Sunny Deol files his nomination from Gurdaspur today. BJP candidate Sunny Deol will file his nomination from Gurdaspur parliamentary constituency today. His father, veteran actor Dharmendra, and actor brother Bobby Deol are likely to be present during the filing. Mr. Deol will also be accompanied by Kavita Khanna, wife of former Gurdaspur MP late Vinod Khanna, and Union Minister Jitendra Singh. The BJP said Sunny Deol faces tough competition with Congress candidate and sitting MP Sunil Jakar, who is the Punjab Congress president. Break record of previous three phases, says Narendra Modi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi reached young people to come out and vote in large numbers and break the records of the previous three phases. He quoted saying, another phase of general elections begin today. I hope those voting today do so in large numbers and break the voting records of the previous three phases. A special appeal to young voters to head to the polling booth and exercise their franchisee. Voters will decide 72 seats spread across the 9 states. The star candidates whose electoral fortunes will be decided include 6 union ministers. Polling for the 7th phase election ends on May 19. The countings of vote will be held on May 23. No face veils in public in Sri Lanka. New regulations announced by President Maithripala Sirisena on Monday, who used emergency powers in the wake of Easter Sunday bombings, that Muslim women in Sri Lanka will not be allowed to wear any form of face veils in public from Monday. The ban is to ensure national security. No one should obscure their faces to make identification difficult. More than 270 people died in Indonesia during election. According to the reports, 10 days after Indonesia held the world's biggest single-day elections, more than 270 election staff have died, mostly of fatigue-related illness caused by long hours of counting millions of ballot papers by hand. Share market to remain shut today due to elections in Mumbai. Due to the fourth phase of Lok Sabha elections, the turnover of the stock market and commodity futures market remained closed due to the voting on Monday in the financial capital Mumbai. Actually, this decision has been taken because of voting in Mumbai West, Mumbai North West, Mumbai North East, Mumbai North Central, Mumbai South Central and Mumbai South under the fourth phases of voting. Alia Bhatt says working with Mahesh Bhatt, the director, will not be easy. Mahesh Bhatt is coming back to the heading with Sadak 2, and the film additionally denotes his first joint effort with his little girl, on-screen character Alia Bhatt. The youthful star says, despite the fact that she comprehends his sensibilities as a dad, working with him as an expert setup would be an alternate ballgame. Karan Johar reveals Kajol had a crush on Akshay Kumar. On the Kapil Sharma show, Karan uncovered that some time ago, Kajol had a smash on none other than Khiladi, Akshay Kumar. This was harking back to the 90s and the two couldn't quit chuckling over the memory as wistfulness hit them hard. Attack on Congress leader Ghazi's house in Delhi. Three miscreants fired at the Congress workers' house in the Ambedkar Nagar area of South Delhi. They escaped by firing at the Congress workers' house late last night. It's being told that the miscreants ran nearly half a dozen rounds of bullets. Two bodies of youth of Bulandshahr found in drain in Greater Noida. Two youths have died in Greater Noida. There was a stir in the city when bodies of two youths missing for 5 days were found in the drain. Avengers Endgame rewrites history as it earns 104 crores in 2 days. The Indian box office has been taken by storm as the movie earned ₹104.50 crore just in the span of 2 days. So that's all from today's top stories. Subscribe and press the bell icon for the latest updates. Stay in touch with us to stay in touch with the world. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram.